Love it or hate it, when it comes time to data science interview at places like Amazon, Google, and Meta, if there's one thing that they'll often ask, it's going to be SQL. The reason why they ask is because SQL is a required skill set in order to build data pipelines, to conduct analysis, and build dashboards. So it's no surprising as to why they ask SQL questions across phone screening and on-site. That's why in this video, I'm going to share three practical tips and give you a sneak peek of a new product that I'll be launching on DataInterview.com. In order to think about how to prioritize your time, you want to think about what's often asked and what's asked in the beginning. And it is going to be SQL problems. So if you were giving yourself about 2 months in order to prepare for data science interviews, then what you should do is that in the first month, allocate at least an hour of your study session just focusing on SQL problems. This is going to ensure that when it comes time to take the phone screen, you'll be well prepared for the SQL questions. Here's the second tip I want to share. You want to practice explaining your solution out loud. It's a little bit unnatural at first to be writing your solution and trying to explain at the same time, but interviewers are expecting you to explain your thought process, not just based on whether you got the right solution or not. So it's really important that you explain your solution out loud. Now, there are one of three ways of how you could explain this. So first way is to create an overall outline or strategy of how you're going to solve that problem and then write your solution. Or you could explain it while you're solving it, or you could solve it first and then explain your solution. Now, depending on which method you use, it really depends on what feels organic to you in terms of how you think through a problem and how you explain things. So what I would do is I would pick the one that best fits for you and then just go with that. Now, here's a third tip I want to share. When you look at documentations like Postgres and MySQL, it almost seems like there's gazillion functions that you need to know. It almost makes your head blow up. Fortunately, there's only a finite set of functions that you need to know. Here's a comprehensive list of it. What I would do is I would take a screenshot of this and go through the concepts that you're not familiar with at the moment. And once you have studied them, I would say you'll be able to solve about 80 to 90% of all kinds of SQL problems from easy, medium, hard, in regards to whatever company will ask it, whether it's Google, Meta, or Amazon. So go through this list and you'll be well prepared for SQL interviews. Now, let me give you a glimpse of Daetama. Daetama is an SQL practice pad that was created by Google and Meta data scientists. All in all, upon launch on June 16, 2022, mark it down in your calendar, it's gonna contain 100 interview questions asked by top tech companies such as Google, Meta, and Amazon. On Daetama, it allows you to filter questions based on company, difficulty, and question type. Now, when you have a question you wanna solve, you get details about the question itself, along with the hint that can help you solve the problem and the expected output, and information about the source tables that are required to solve the problem. You can also take a glimpse of that source table by clicking the preview button. Now, when you're ready to solve it, you can type it and execute it, or you can look at the solution and run it. Now, what it's going to do behind the scene is see whether the output that you wrote, it matches with the expected output. And if you get it correct, then it will say congratulations. So if you're looking for extra practice you need in order to ace SQL data science interview questions, check out dataintv.com/Daetama and enter your email and we will send you a 50% discount code when we launch on June 16, 2022. Now let me show you the power of Daetama as a way to practice SQL problems. So here's a question that's similar to the ones asked by Google. Which websites had users who clicked but never had users who converted? To solve this problem, we need the following information. What is the expected output in this case? And it's going to be the URL of the websites that satisfy the condition where the websites had users who clicked but never had users who converted. And we also need information about the source tables. The Google search activity table and Google search websites are the tables that we need. The activity table contains key information like event, session, user, website ID, creation date, advertisement, event type. Of course, not all of the columns are needed in order to solve this problem. And then there's also the Google search websites, and we need the website ID and URL. All right, let's try to solve this problem together. Along the way, if you want to try this out, make sure you write in the comment below and I'll provide feedback for the first 10 comments. To solve this problem, I would say that the first step is to think about what website IDs we need. So we need the website IDs that had clicks but no conversion. So right off the bat, I can think about a couple keywords we probably need. We probably need distinct, we need where, we need some subquery, and we probably need to do some sort of joins as a way to get the website IDs that had the clicks but no conversion. So I'm gonna go ahead and write the series of expressions. So The first step is to get the select the website ID. And this is going to come from the left join of two tables in this case. So the first table is going to be a subquery where you select the website ID from the Google search activity where the event type is equal to clicked. And you're going to do a left join of this, a variation of the subquery table, where this time around you're actually filtering on converted. And you're going to join it on the primary key, which is going to be website ID. All right, so what am I trying to do in this left join? Basically, whatever website IDs that are found in that converted subquery table are going to match with the website ID that are found in the click subquery. And if it's missing in this case, then the website ID in the converted subquery table is going to be null. And that null value basically represents the website IDs that had clicks, but that never had conversion. And that's what we want to isolate in this case. And so what I'm going to do on this join table is I'm going to apply a where condition where, and I think I also need a subquery alias in this case. So I'm going to call this the SQ clicked, and I'll call this SQ converted. And so I'm going to do a filter where the SQ converted website ID is null. So now this is going to return the website IDs. And I think I also need to mention which website IDs I actually want to select in this case. And what I want to select is going to be the SQ clicked. Okay, great. So what this ultimately returns are the website IDs that had users who clicked but never had users who converted. But we're not done yet because we need the website IDs in order to get the URL of the websites. So we actually need to do another join in this case. And instead of wrapping this into a subquery, since we've already used subquery here, we actually want to reduce the complexity of this query statement and use a CTE function. So I'm going to call this with, and let's just call this the selected website ID as, and got to wrap it in this parenthesis here. And just for style reasons, I'm going to indent that. And now what I will do is I'll call the names or the URL of the website in this case. So it's going to be URL from the Google search websites where the website ID found in this table is being filtered by the website ID found in the CTE function. So I'm going to call this the select website ID from selected website ID. And when I try to run this, what I get is a wrong solution. I think the problem is the fact that I'm using equals instead of is. So if I replace that and run this, then what I get is the correct solution. Voila. So here's a demonstration of how you can use Daetama as a way to practice SQL. I can't wait for you to try this once it launches on June 16th. And along the way, if you need any additional prep for data science interview, whether it's coaching or courses, make sure you check out DataInterview.com. I'll see you in the next video.